HMS Queen Elizabeth sailed only from build in a site in Scotland just over a little over a year ago. And since then, we've embarked our first rotary aircraft, our helicopters. We've got to know the ship and make sure she works properly. And here we are, 40 months later, crossing the Atlantic. We've crossed the Atlantic, arriving in the state of Florida, which is fantastic for my ship's company, many of whom haven't been to America before. But also just signposting the future about the close links we're going to have with the American Armed Forces, particularly the US Navy and the US Marine Corps, as this ship, this new aircraft carrier from Britain, goes forward hand in hand with the Americans.
So it's appropriate that for our first real voyage, we are going to America because of the close links. Tell me a bit more about that.
Yes, of course, the Royal Navy has operated with the US Navy and the US Marine Corps for many decades, right from the Second World War. And of course, the linkages with carriers and nuclear submarines and intelligence flow is as strong as they ever have been. This ship, HMS Queen Elizabeth, will be embarking the new F-35B Lightning, the same aircraft type the US Marine Corps operating. And we're looking forward greatly to having the US Marine Corps on board this ship. And that's a great level of trust. We have the same values, we speak the same language, and we operate in the same parts of the world. So this is just the next step on the evolution of that relationship, and one I'm looking forward to hugely.
And in terms of a comparison, if you can, between this carrier and the more familiar carriers that the people of the United States would see, what is the real comparison there? How do they compare?
Well, when you look at HMS Queen Elizabeth and her sister, HMS Prince of Wales, and the American carriers, there's a lot of similarities. Roughly the same sort of size. We deliver the same effect, if you like, for the government, which is a strategic message, but also operating a lot of the same aircraft types, not least the F-35 Lightning aircraft. And so there's huge similarities, which is why we can work so closely together. We'll have American personnel on this ship in the future, and of course we've got British personnel on American aircraft carriers. That is how close that linkage and relationship is. But fundamentally, they do the same job. They deliver air power wherever it's needed.
And there will always be that relationship and the interoperability over the lifespan of this ship.
I think we all recognise that the world is dangerous, it's fluid, it's pretty dynamic. At the end of the day, the United States is the leader of the Western Union, as, if you like, the policeman of the world, as the superpower absolute. That the United Kingdom, and through NATO, of course, which is our key organisation, we have to continue to work hand in hand very, very closely. You only have to look at history to realize that conflict and war, sadly, is only a moment away. And we have to be prepared, we have to be ready. We absolutely must work together to be able to respond to whatever the world throws up. And that relationship between the United States and the United Kingdom is fundamental to our security. We want to do our part, and the Royal Navy is coming to the United States now to take that relationship that next step further with the ship. It's fantastic.
And the landing on board of the F-35, again, that will be a huge moment for you, the ship's company, the Royal Navy, the UK and the USA.
Well, the last time the Royal Navy had a fixed wing aircraft at sea was just about 8 years ago. And it's been a long 8 years, but here we are back again, putting fixed wing aircraft, the F-35B Lightning, back on a Royal Naval deck. You know, it's a fantastic opportunity for the future. My word, it's been a hard challenge getting the ship out of build. This is the largest warship the Royal Navy has ever had in a 1,000-year history. And her sister, HMS Prince of Wales, is shortly to be delivered from her builders up in Scotland. And soon we're going to be back in the carrier game. The Royal Navy started the carrier journey. The Americans have taken it forth and expanded it brilliantly. And here we are, maybe not the same numbers as the Americans, but in terms of capability and expectation, we're right back in. So hugely exciting for us. And we're looking forward to that first jet landing on board in a few weeks' time.